Now, let me be clear about a few things. Obviously, the actions, there is a purpose, and as the sponsor stated, it is a very narrowly tailored bill that is aimed at a particular organization and some of the actions that they have taken as an organization. While I may agree with the actions that this organization, while I may disagree with the actions that this organization has taken as it relates to Israel in that particular case, I think that this bill is much more broad than that, and it is why I must oppose it. In the case of for our professors in our academic institutions, and I'm actually an educator myself. I came originally to New York in 1998 to do a PhD in political science. I found politics, and I have not gone back since. But you know, my dad insisted I should, and I eventually go back. Technically, I'm a PhD student at the CUNY Graduate Center in the city, and I still teach to this day. Some of my colleagues, when they're seeking tenure, tenure requires scholarship, and scholarship requires academic freedom. And in this case, what we're saying is certainly it is an action narrowly tailored to limit the actions of a particular or to protest, for lack of a better term, from the state's perspective, the actions of one particular institution. The issue that I have with this is that regardless of what that institution, in this case ASA, has done, what we are saying is that we are, as a state, taking a position on what is right or not right to say. Not to get too wordy, but to paraphrase Voltaire, I might hate what you say, but I'll defend it. I will defend your right to say it with my life. So in this case, what we're saying here is that it would affect not only ASA, but it could potentially impact a professor or another academic institution that might not even agree with the actions of ASA. If an organization sponsors strictly work on a particular, you know, in the case of ASA, let's say that they sponsor issues, they sponsor academic conferences and such that are strictly on the issue of Israel, then certainly. But if they do scholarship on other issues, if they do on state budgeting, on environmental conservation, on labor issues, and if there is a professor or faculty member that wants to actually go and participate in something that they that organization has sponsored that has nothing to do with a position that they have taken on another issue, then you are impacting the ability of that particular professor, and in the case of the academic institution that might sponsor him or her to go to this conference, you're limiting their ability to be able to practice their scholarship, and you're indeed, in that case, limiting their academic freedom. So I would say that it is not, in this bill, unfortunately, I think discourages scholarship, and I don't believe that government should be in the business of sanctioning speech. Now, whether we agree with the actions of ASA or not, we can certainly make all sorts of statements, and I will say that certainly as a private institution, they have, whether they have made the wrong decision or not by trying to limit the ability of their members to participate with academic institutions from Israel, it is not in the business, or it should not be in the business of the state, to say that we are going to limit the amount of funding that we're going to provide to an academic institution because we disagree with the actions of something like ASA. So unfortunately, although I certainly understand where it's coming from, I think that it is not narrowly tailored enough. And unfortunately, I think might discourage, it opens up a door that I believe we should not open as it relates to scholarly work in the state of New York. So fortunately, I will have to vote in the negative.